Welcome to September. Here's your psychic tarot reading for the month. This month, this is what we will go over. We will cover your current self, the month's theme, you at the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the key goal to achieve, how to do it, obstacles to overcome, how to do it, good news, what to avoid, your spirituality modality of focus this month to help you get through it. And then I wanted to let you know that when I polled people on Instagram and on Facebook, they all said what they really wanted to focus on this month was money and career. So I will be putting that in a separate set of videos for you this month to this YouTube channel, and hit the little bell notification so that when those come out, you are immediately aware and alerted in case you like these. I would also appreciate it if you would share these videos with people that you think would find helpful, because otherwise how are they going to find them, right? And here's something new that we're doing this month. If you are to go ahead and share this video on Facebook or Instagram, please go ahead and tag me, because this month I'm giving away a zodiac sign necklace, which obviously it would be the one. If you're a Pisces, that'd be the one that you want to share, right? In this picture, this is an example of the different Pisces necklaces that would be going out, but I have them for every single sign. Those would be shipped out halfway through the month, so make sure that you tag me in it. Because if you don't, I can't see the post, and then I can't DM you for your shipping address. So I'll be giving away one for each one of these signs. Let's get started. Hey Aquarius, welcome to September. Your current self, focusing on the positive, even when things are not going so well. But it's not like things are going horrible. You're just doing a really awesome job of being an optimist. They're saying there's really not that much to do, nothing really too exciting to look forward to. So even if you were like, hey, I'm so excited about back to school, like it started and you're like, okay, now what? But this is actually a very solid, kind of predictable, safe and secure, happy month for you, despite the fact that there's not a tremendous amount to look forward to, at least so far. The month's theme is kind of like things ending, okay? Things getting completed, putting a pretty little bow on them. But there are things that probably we wanted to have end. It's nothing dramatic. It's like, oh, awesome, I finally got that done. Oh, awesome, I finally got that done. So you're using this Virgo energy in the month of September to its maximum capacity, to its advantage. A lot of people are actually not feeling super comfortable with this energy, so it's fantastic that you're able to like cross all these things off your to-do list. The biggest challenge for you this month is going to be kind of really thinking about what is it that I need to do to nurture myself, and like in an emotional way, not in a self-care way, but like how do I really care for my own feelings? They're saying you're not necessarily being super empathetic with yourself, although you can be empathetic with others. You're maybe a little bit critical of yourself this month, not completely satisfied. What else? They're saying you like we might be forgetting to be to express a lot of gratitude for the things that are not going wrong, right? When something out of the blue that's amazing comes out, we're like, oh my gosh, thank you. It's so easy to express gratitude in that moment. But there are a lot of things that we take for granted, and it's important to also express gratitude for those things. I'm so thankful that I'm healthy, right? Before we get sick. We're not even thankful for our health until we're sick, until we're ill, right? So anyway, the other theme for this month is cooperation, and they're saying manifesting the energy of love into relationships with other people and understanding that all people have value. So it's not saying like you're judgmental, but like, you know, when we think about these like very existential topics, like why is there evil in the world? Well, because it gives good people a chance to express their love and goodness and kindness. Otherwise, would we take it for granted? Maybe. If we didn't have anything to contrast against, right? And that's a very simple answer to a very nuanced and complicated question. But just so you have an understanding of what I'm talking about here. So you at the beginning of the month, maybe not feeling super happy over the moon, content, but that'll quickly shift and change as we get to the middle of the month. In the middle of the month, this is where we're really going to start experiencing those endings. And for some of us, that might be hard. It might be like, you know what? I put 10 years of practice into playing the piano, but I don't think it's for me anymore, and I don't want to keep pursuing lessons at this point. Now I want to go learn the saxophone. You know, it's about something that we really truly loved. We put a lot of energy, time, and emotion into, and then now it's like, okay, but now I'm going to go do this other thing, and I'm kind of excited about it, even though there's a lot of nostalgia and attachment. And, you know, good feelings, and maybe not even good feelings. Some of us, this is a relationship. It's like, I put 10 years into trying to fix, you know, what was wrong in that relationship, trying to grow and become like the best partner I could be and, you know, pull my partner up. And like, oh man, I can't believe I spent 10 years there, but now it's time to go find something else. And don't be critical like you wasted your time, because nothing that we do is a waste. We learn something in every experience, right? Time is going to pass no matter what. So it's just, you know, we could have wasted time with somebody else or in a different situation or a different workplace, but no matter what, time passes. So don't be critical of yourself, okay? Now, when we get to the end of the month, because what I'm saying basically is whatever it is that we put a lot of time, energy, and love into, it's a good thing that we're moving forward, okay? At the end of the month, they're like, hey, not so many choices here as to like what's going on and what's happening in our world. We're maybe feeling like we literally can't even, like circumstances are happening to us and around us that are not really things that we had planned for necessarily, and it's a lot of work, but you can do it. So this would be, for example, if you're at work and you know you're going about your day, and then all of a sudden your boss says, holy shit, like we have to complete this giant stack of paperwork within the next 5 days, and is like, and I need you to do this, like our company's going to be a sinking ship without it. And it, like, that has nothing to do with you, but somehow you have to do the work, right? And that sucks. But you can get through it. You can do it. It's not like you manifested any of this kind of bullshit into your life. It's just like, you know, buckle down, hammer it out kind of energy. You can. Your key goal to achieve, and they're like, hey, when you're feeling unhappy, this is when we want you to work on this goal. Don't go deep within. Don't close yourself off. Aquariuses do need a lot of their own alone time and space, but this month specifically, this is going to make us particularly more unhappy. When usually we use that time to build ourselves up, to recharge, to disconnect from all the energies of other people and, you know, kind of get our own energy back. They're like, this month is a little bit different, and where that might kind of drain or suck your energy a little bit more. This is a month where you definitely do not want to be taking as much alone time and space as you typically do, because for whatever reason, this month in particular, it's counterproductive. It does the opposite of its intent and what it usually does for you. So how should we go about kind of, you know, manipulating and using these energies to our advantage? And they're saying, like, we're not even saying, like, you have to go anywhere or do anything. You can call people to you. You can still be in your little she shed or man cave, but on a FaceTime with a friend. Or you can have friends come over to your house. You don't have to leave this comfortable space and environment so that it still feels sort of alone, but it's not alone. You're alone together, sort of, right? Obstacles that you'll want to overcome this month. They're saying when it comes to your intuition, you're going to be pretty spot on. There's a lot of things that you're just going to kind of claircognizantly know or feel. And what they're saying about that is, though, we don't want to tell other people. So I might have a bad feeling about a friend's new boyfriend, right? And like, ooh, I don't like that guy. And usually when I feel this way, like I have 100% accuracy rate of kind of like knowing that this is a bad idea. I don't want to tell her this month. What happens if you do go around communicating what you're kind of understanding and they're like a lot of pain and hurt, not just for you, but for other people, okay? A different example would be like, ooh, I've got this like awesome idea that I want to pursue. And then you tell somebody else, and then they tell somebody else who immediately steals your idea, right? And so there went your long-term plan for financial stability and security, right? Speaking of finances, at the end of this video, there's a link to your career and money video for the month. I don't usually do two videos, but this month everybody was like, I specifically want career and money reading for September when I pulled them on Instagram and Facebook. So that's what we're doing. So they're like, look, if you're to communicate these feelings that you have, people, it's going to come across bitchy, even if it's not intended that way. Even if you know how they say, like, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. This time it's opposite. No matter what you say, it's going to come across as like your intentions are bitchy and hurtful, and it's gonna damage relationships, and it's maybe even gonna end some relationships and friendships. So just keep it to yourself, basically. You know, anything that you're intuiting, positive or negative, a great idea or a bad feeling, keep it to yourself in the month of September, for real. So some good news for the month, Aquarius. They're like, whatever it is that you're going to be pursuing next when something ends, that thing that you're giving up and moving forwards towards is going to be worthwhile. It's going to be fantastic. And that you're finally doing it. Maybe you've been thinking about it for a long time. And then they're like, when we're talking about what to avoid this month, they're just saying essentially the same thing that they just said, you know, make sure that you're kind of keeping your mouth shut when it comes to our spiritual insights, okay? Now, the spirituality modality of focus for you this month to help you get through these energies and to handle them to the best of your ability is actually through prayer. If we're not feeling good about something, if we're not clear on something, if we need greater insight, if we need to purge some energy or we need guidance, prayer is the way to do it. And whether, you know, it doesn't matter if you have a formal religion or not, or a formal way of praying or not, it can just be like a thought, you know, like, hey, whatever, whoever's out there, I'd like some guidance on this. And then go about your day and, you know, just wait for those intuitive insights to just drop in your mind or to hear them in a song. Everybody's clair is different. Some people get messages through numbers, some through music, some, you know, have the visions, but some through dreams. Anyway, I love you so much and I'll see you in October. Thanks for getting all the way to the end of this video with me. Click here to sign up to win a free 20-minute video reading. Click here if you want to see the career and money video. And click here to subscribe.